dear friends, welcome back to my channel. Sorry for the long uploads. So we are gonna learn about basics of plants physiology now. So do plants has movements? Yes, it obviously has movements. Animals move in search of food, shelter, and for reproduction. Do plants show such movements? Have you observed the leaves of touch me not plant? It closes on touching. So these movements are triggered by the external stimuli. Unlike animals, plants do not move on their own from one place to another, but can move their body of getting sunlight, water, and nutrients. They are sensitive to external factors like light, gravity, and temperature. So now we will enter to the topic of trophism in plants. So what does mean by this trophism? So trophism is a unidirectional movement of a whole or part of a plant towards the direction of stimuli. So what is the stimuli? The requirement of the plant's food nutrients, etc. So types of trophism, there are the types of trophisms also. So let us see the types of trophism. There are four types of trophism. What are the four types of trophism are? So simply trophism is called movement. Simply trophism is called movement. So types of trophisms are phototrophism, geotrophism, and hydrotrophism. So this phototrophism is a movement of a plant part towards light. So photo is nothing else, light. So movement of a plant towards the light, which is nothing else, sunlight. Example, shoot of a plant. So next is geotrophism. Geo means nothing else, gravity. So the movement of geotrophism is movement of a plant is responsible to the gravity. Example, root of a plant. Mostly the root of the plant will be inside the ground. So it is an example of the geotrophism. Hydrotrophism is nothing else, the movement of a plant path of a plant towards water. Example, root of a plant. Some plants has roots inside the water also. So the example, that is hydrotrophism. So next is cymotrophism. What is this cymotrophism? Cymotrophism is movement of a part of a plant is responsible to chemicals. Some of the plants will move for the chemical reactions also. So example, growth of a palm tube is responsible for the sugar presence of the stigma. So these are the types of trophisms. So the movements of the plant is of two types. What are there are trophism and trophic movement and nastic movement. So today we learned about trophic movement. Next video will be about nastic movements. Please do waiting for it, and please do like, share, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to click on bell icon. Thank you so much for watching.